Good Sunday evening, everybody. Live and direct from downtown Memphis, Tennessee, I'm meteorologist Austin Onick. Thanks for joining us for a quick weather update of our video weather blog called Weather Overtime. If you've never been here before, I'm down here in the lower left-hand corner of your screen. And as of right now, we're seeing again some very quiet conditions for the Mid-South. A beautiful Sunday evening coming up. If you have any sunset pictures, weather pictures across the Mid-South, we'd love to see them. Please send them along to us. Again, the social media networks I'm on over there. Still working on Snapchat. I'll get that taken care of eventually, but so far just haven't really had the chance to get all that smoothed out as of right now. The app's been giving me a lot of problems, but more information on the weather right here at our website address at wreg.com/weather, so stay tuned for more on that. Currently, again, for the rest of the day today, temperatures back in the lower to mid 80s. Later on tonight, looking at temperatures back in the mid 60s, so not doing too bad on the numbers overnight. We'll take a look at the complete forecast coming up here as we round out the weekend and head into next week. Things are pretty quiet again for right now. We're not seeing any major concerns out across the Mid-South, but we may be looking at some more changes coming our way into the near future. We'll talk about that in just a little bit. No earthquakes to report in the last 24 hours, according to the Center for Earthquake Research and Information at the University of Memphis or from the United States Geological Survey. Reports of something happening over toward western Arkansas, southern Missouri. Large shockwave of some sort early this morning, about 8 to 10 hours ago, somewhere in there, as reported on social media, but so far nothing having to do with the New Madrid Fault, so definitely good news on that. If you'd like to see more information on this, all you have to do is go to usgs.gov. The best website is earthquakes.usgs.gov, or go to the Center for Earthquake Research and Information at the University of Memphis at memphis.edu/CERI for more details as to what's going on. Rhodes College coming up on sunset. Should be a gorgeous view for tonight. This view particularly from the Weather Underground system in and around central Memphis, so a beautiful shot from early Sunday evening. Ole Miss on the campus looking from Crosby Hall south to the construction area in and around the area of the Ole Miss Student Union. Plenty of sunshine, some beautiful blue skies up above, and tons of websites available, webcams available from, again, Ole Miss. Some available, we'll post them every once in a while through wreg.com/weather, but you can get there by going to livecams.olemiss.edu for more information about various views. Germantown, plenty of sunshine, approaching sunset. This is really neat for right now because the humidity levels, well, the wind is kind of nice, that kind of stirs the air around a little bit, but humidity levels are way down. We've gotten a big burst of dry air in here, and things are very nice for the time being. So 31% humidity, that is bone dry air. Nowhere close to the very warm and muggy air that we started off the weekend with, so things are much improved from what we saw just about 24 hours ago. And so far, not seeing anything approaching the area. A very pleasant evening coming up. Temperatures as we go through sunset will begin to fall off by just a little bit. Still in the lower to mid 80s or so. Again, very pleasant conditions in the backyard. But we should be heading for the lower 70s by the time we're on the air with News Channel 3 at 10 later on this evening. And throughout the rest of the night, not expecting too much. But as we get into around the area very early tomorrow morning, say around Dawn Patrol, more chances of rainfall coming our way, but very light in nature. Doesn't look like a washout. Definitely doesn't look like severe weather. We'll take a look at that coming up here in just a little bit. Here's what it looks like as we run the numbers into the overnight period of time, heading toward about News Channel 3 at 10. Not much happening. Again, fairly dry, very pleasant conditions. Temperatures back into the lower to mid 70s. And a few mid to upper 60s by the time we hit News Channel 3 at 10 as well. Now, early into tomorrow morning, by the time we get into past midnight and around the area very early, you start to notice again some more clouds starting to make their way into the area. That's part of a new storm system coming in from the northwest. But here's the thing. Computer model's not in good agreement, and as of right now, the current situation is that confidence is not high that we're going to be getting a lot of moisture with this. If you're around Dyersburg, the Boot Heel, Blytheville, into around areas back up into portions of Missouri, that's where we start to see more chances of sprinkles. And keep in mind that, first of all, number one, this is very light amount of moisture. Number two, this is going to be moving its way through and heading on down to the south end of the east into relatively dry air. So it's a good possibility that a lot of what we're looking at here into tomorrow morning is not going to be surviving, but a few raindrops, I would guess, would not be out of the question as we look around, again, northwest Tennessee, the Boot Heel, and northeastern Arkansas. Now, getting into the rest of the forecast toward tomorrow, again, some of that moisture could bring some drips and drizzles here and there, but nothing really major taking place at this point, from mid to upper 70s to around lower 80s for the time we hit lunchtime and early afternoon tomorrow. Looking pretty good there. And by tomorrow evening, that system again could strengthen to give us a little bit more activity in the form of maybe showers and a few thunderstorms north of us. But once again, this is going into, again, dropping on down toward the south and to the east, relatively dry air heading our way. So confidence is really just not that high of seeing a lot out there, but some remnant rainfall, yeah, that's a good possibility as we get into the course of the end of the weekend, and in this case, as we go toward around the area of Monday night. That's where we start to see, again, more chances of rain out there. Let's run the numbers and give you an idea as to what's going on with the forecast for tomorrow. Temperatures going back into the mid-80s, and again, that chance of rainfall, we're going to throw in a 10%, less than 10% chance for much of the area. Could be a little stronger in some locations if we get a decent concentrated burst of rain heading on through that could survive tearing apart from all that very dry air. So that's something to take a look at if you live up around that particular area. Again, mainly north of I-40, that's where we're going to be seeing better chances of that. But by dinner time tomorrow night, that's where we start to see, again, the potential for more rainfall drifting its way into the area. A 20% chance early on Tuesday of a few showers. Again, that's that system coming on through. But once again, drier in place, confidence not high with the models, and this is an overland system, so it's not bringing in any moisture from the Gulf of Mexico, so good news on that. Back to sunshine on Wednesday, and that means the temperatures are going one direction upwards and staying on the warm side as we get into the course of the next several days. Temperatures back into around the mid to upper 80s through about midweek. That's also where we start to see more chances of rainfall popping up, with numbers back into around 40 to 50% Friday, Saturday, and Sunday. That's going to round out the area of June and head us into July. After that, as we go into around Independence Day coming up next Tuesday, that's where we see, again, the potential for, again, the possibility of maybe some more showers and thunderstorms out there. But so far, it just does not appear to be a major threat at this time for anything involving the possibility of rainfall dampening the fireworks displays on the 4th of July. But once again, we will keep an eye on that, so keep it tuned to News Channel 3. Want to see the entire 10-day forecast? Drop by and get more information and on the 10 o'clock news coming up later on this evening. Taking a quick peek into the tropics, there's really not much going on at this time, which is very good news. Last week, we were watching Cindy form in the Western Gulf, and as of right now, we do have Dora in the Pacific. It's a tropical storm. Winds are increasing. It's expected to follow a line, making its way back up the northwestern Mexican coast, heading possibly toward Baja, but no threat to the rest of the United States, at least at this time. Back into the Gulf, the Caribbean, and into the Atlantic, the really good news at this point is we have nothing going on. According to the National Hurricane Center, things are quiet, not much of anything going on, but it doesn't take much to get one of these storm systems started, so stay tuned to News Channel 3. It's expected to be a decently active season, so we'll be watching this with a lot of interest as we go throughout the course of the next several days and weeks. We've got months to go in hurricane season. It ends on December 1st, so it's going to be a while. Keep up to date with our app. Search WREG Weather from whatever platform you've got out there, and a good opportunity to learn more about what's going on with weather in and around the Mid-South. Also, don't forget to tune in throughout the rest of what's left of the weekend for my forecast on Country 92.5, Oldies 102.3. I'll be on with Bob and Josh starting at 7 o'clock tomorrow morning with more of your forecast available from the News Channel 3 Weather Center. That's on AM 730. Tune in for Talkback Live, sports chat, great guests, all kinds of great things to take a look at, all available there. And, of course, I'm available on all these social media networks, so stay tuned for more on that. We'll have more details in the forecast coming up tonight on News Channel 310. Also, thank you very much to everybody who sent along pictures this weekend. We had a whole bunch of great ones out across the Mid-South. Going to be showing a few more of those coming up again later on tonight, and more details about the rest of the week involving the end of June and some more rainfall coming on through. We'll have more of that coming up in just a little bit. Should be right here. Not too sure why it's not showing up. Email address austin.onick@wrag.com. If there's something you would like to see on here, let me know about it, and we'd be glad to feature it on our Weather Overtime video weather blog, or you can contact me through this website, wreg.com/weather, and be glad to give you more information about what's going on in the Mid-South. I can't post it on here if you don't send it, so let me know what you'd like to see, and we'd be glad to do what we can to keep you coming back for more information for our video weather blog information here. Live and direct from downtown Memphis on a very nice Sunday evening, I'm meteorologist Austin Onick. Stay tuned for more coming up tonight on News Channel 3 on air and online and throughout the rest of the week with with the News Channel 3 severe weather experts.